You all have heard a lot about health and fitness. You all know that Fit India movement was declared by our Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji on 29th of August this year, 2019. And we are celebrating Fit India Movement Week in this week, and under the guidance of Central Board of Secondary Education, CBSE, and the Government of India. And in this week, we are going to have a variety of programs, and all these programs will be based on the fitness. So when we talk about health and fitness, so health is a state of mind. When we talk about health, it doesn't mean that we should be physically healthy. Health, when we talk about health, it is the mental health, social health, your physical health, etc. It comprises of all three of them. And when we talk about fitness, so health and fitness. Fitness gives you a, you can say, fitness is a part of health, because once we will be fit, then only we will be cope up with our day-to-day activities. You all know that today's life is full of stress. So how to be healthy and fit? It is a challenge for all of us, because you are also being the student. You are young. It is easy for you to be healthy and fit, but due to pressure, due to stress, because you are also passing through the stress exams one after another, there is a stress of the parents, there is a pressure from the parents and from your teachers also to secure and to perform well. That is good, but that state, the stressed condition can be avoided. I am going to tell you five basic things which are required to be healthy and fit. So the number one is the healthy diet. So, and you know, balanced diet is very, very important. One of the student has told that the milk is the balanced diet. So you must include milk in your diet. I have seen so many students, they fell down during the morning assembly when it has been extended for some more time due to one or the other program. So once you are coming to school, like your school starts with 7:15 or 7:20, so you must have a glass of milk at least, because milk is a complete diet and that will help you to remain healthy. Okay, and you have to include, as you all know, that balanced diet comprises of carbohydrate, fat, then protein, then vitamins, minerals, water, etc. and roughage also. So nutrition is one of the important thing for being healthy. The second comes the exercise. So you must include exercise in your day-to-day activity, because that will help you to be fit and healthy. Exercise is very, very important. Then the sleep is also very, very important. Sleep. Sometimes we study till late night, or because of we are busy in our mobiles or in some other gadgets, and we are not giving proper rest to our body. So you mind it, my dear children, that sleep is very, very important, and you should have a sleep of at least 7 to 8 hours. Those who are taking less than 7 to 8 hours of sleep, for you people, 8 hours of sleep is must. I personally ensure that I should get at least 8 hours of sleep, because that helps you. Why sleep is important? Because sleep helps you to, you can say, give rest to your body. There is regeneration of the lost body parts, lost muscles. It helps in the healing of your body. So that is why sleep relaxes you, rather, I can say. So sleep is very, very important. Then comes the role of water. As you all know, that 70% of your body is made up of water. So drinking water is very, very important. Hydration is very, very important. and you must ensure that at least you should have drinking of water at regular interval. I was attending the seminar of one of the doctor, and then I came to know that water is very, very important because it keeps your cell hydrated. Your mind is made up of nerve cells, neurons, and if you want that your mind should work optimally, you should have water at regular interval, especially during the exam time. Because during the exam time, your mind has to work in the most active way. It has to work optimally, and for that it is necessary that you should have water after every 20-30 minutes, at least a sip of water. So that will help you to keep your mind active. And then comes is de-stressing. De-stressing is very, very important. So because stress is the regular feature of our life, we cannot avoid stress. As you all know that today's life is full of, you can say, we have a very hectic schedule from the morning. So we get stressed, and the examination pressure, the pressure of performing good in the class, and rather you can say excellent. Every parent has a dream that my child should perform excellently well, above 90%. So these causes stress also. So de-stressing is very, very important. I hope if you all will stick with these five points, you will remain healthy and you will be the part of the healthy India. Thank you so much.